What is a chiropractic subluxation? You can be guaranteed you're going to get this slapped in your face. Doctor, you treat asthmas and allergies and subluxation. I mean, this is going to come smack you in the face. And any good attorney, defense attorney, is going to come and throw this at you and throw it at you hard because they know it sounds ridiculous. They know it sounds absolutely ridiculous that you're treating asthma, allergies, and bedwetting and the immune system and cancer. They know it's absolutely ridiculous to an eighth grade educated juror. So you can be guaranteed you're going to be getting this stuff. Thank you, Subba Wubba. So here we go. How do you handle it? First thing you have to do is you have to handle it. You better bring it up before they bring it up. You better bring it up. So that's why I say, doctor, what is a chiropractic subluxation? And by the way, be aware there's a difference between a chiropractic subluxation and a medical subluxation. A medical subluxation is a partial dislocation. Okay, so our definition of a chiropractic subluxation is very unique and different. So what is a chiropractic subluxation? Oh my God. Let me line up 10 chiropractors and let's see what 10 different chiropractors have to say. Okay? Now, I'm going to share with you just how I would handle it. So what is a chiropractic subluxation? A chiropractic subluxation is simply, it's what's called a somatovisceral reflex. A somatovisceral reflex. What that means is part of your nervous system, your autonomic nervous system, so it's a special part of your nervous system, essentially controls the off-on, start-stop mechanisms. If you were to make it real simple term, on, off, start, stop, of your organs, your liver, your intestines, your lungs, your heart, okay? It's called your autonomic nervous system. And there's what's called a somatovisceral reflex, where if there's any interference with a somatovisceral reflex, it can affect the off, on, or start, stop of any of those organs. That's a somatovisceral reflex. So that's what a subluxation is when there's any interference with a somatovisceral reflex that affects the autonomic nervous system, that increases or decreases the start-stop or the on-off, essentially, of your organs. That's a very simple way to explain what a chiropractic subluxation is to an eighth grade educated juror, okay? Now, does a chiropractor treat visceral symptoms? Now, you're gonna have to go into this. Does a chiropractor treat visceral symptoms such as asthma, allergies? Okay, this is where you have a real chance of destroying your credibility, how you answer these right here. To the eighth grade educated public right here. This has to be very clean how you handle this. So does a chiropractor treat visceral symptoms? So when I have my attorney answer that, I'll say that is not the typical chiropractic patient. But what happens is on occasion, if there's a somatovisceral reflex, then on occasion, in rare occasion, it can help. If it's a somatovisceral reflex and we help stimulate or regulate the somatovisceral reflex that affects the nervous system that controls the start-stop or the on-off systems to your lungs. So on occasion, does that happen? Yes. Is that what the majority of chiropractors, patients see chiropractors for? No. Matter of fact, it's very rare that it ever happens. See, that's how I'm going to answer that question. I'm going to sound like a responsible adult.